Hello friends, welcome back to Nanami's Kitchen. On the menu today is my tasty oven grilled chicken quarters, a dish that's guaranteed to bring you, your friends, and your family together to have a great time. So let's get started.
Yes, friends. So my preferred choice of meat is chicken quarters, a combination of the thigh and the drum. They've been cleaned thoroughly with hot water, removed any excess skin, any excess fat, and even feathers, and they're ready to go. So it is dark meat, so it tastes more flavorful. It doesn't dry out when baked, so it's perfect for this recipe. Now, this oil is over low heat. I'm going to be extracting the flavors of my rosemary, garlic, onion, ginger, habanero, serrano chilies. It's going to cook for 20 minutes over low heat until caramelized. Then I'm gonna let all of this cool down before I blend my marinade. So what I do is I remove all the caramelized ingredients and blend them up with half of the oil. Now I just added suya spice mix. Now suya spice mix is a West African roasted peanut based spice rub that is perfect on any meat, vegetables, fruits, seafood. It is just a very beautiful ingredient. It is just lovely. And I have a video on how I actually prepared this. And the video is linked in my description box below. So please, please check it out. Make a lot of it and you can use it. It's versatile. So I have blended all of that up and I just added some salt to my chicken and I'm going to rub my marinade into every chicken piece so that it's well coated. Every chicken quarter is well coated with this beautiful marinade. Now I'm sprinkling some more suya spice mix onto my chicken quarters and it's going to marinate overnight. For the best results, friends, you might want to overnight marinating. It will marinate the chicken pieces right to the bone, making it delicious through and through. So this chicken has been overnight marinated in my refrigerator. I reserved two of the pieces because I will be incorporating that in my party jollof rice recipe coming up in a couple of days, possibly hours. So make sure you check it out. So now this chicken is ready to go into the oven, but before we do that, I'm adding some more aromatics, fresh aromatics. These are red, these are bell peppers, red, orange, green, as you can see. I reserved actually from my fried rice, my vegetable fried rice preparation. I had a lot of it left over, so I thought, why not include them? It'll give it more flavor, and there you have it. For 20 minutes, I baked this chicken at 450 degrees Fahrenheit. See how the chicken skin is crackling? The perfect result you want. So now we're gonna flip it because we want that color throughout, that caramelized color and flavor throughout and consistent throughout. So there you go. Now let's check the inner temperature of this chicken. We want at least 160 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's how you cook chicken. You want it to be cooked thoroughly. Very important, friends. If your chicken is not cooked through, you could get sick from eating it. You could end up with salmonella poisoning, which causes typhoid fever. Not so hot, guys. So make sure you cook your chicken thoroughly. So now we flipped it. It went back into the oven. And we cooked it only 5 minutes this time using the broil option. Now let's talk about the difference between broiling and baking. So baking cooks whatever item you're cooking from within to the outside. So it cooks it through, okay? So in this case, it cooked it to the bone. So that's what baking does. And broiling only cooks the surface, so it doesn't get through into the to the inner portion of the item you're cooking. You use broiling to achieve a consistent caramelized flavor and color, and also to sear whatever it is you're cooking, so it traps the juices. Now if you do broiling for too long, it can dry out your item, so make sure you only do it for a few minutes. In this case, we only did it for 5 minutes. So we flipped everything, added some more sea spice mix, and my oil I reserved from the beginning with the sea spice mix incorporated into it has been drizzled on, and some more aromatics, onions, bell peppers, and some rosemary have been added, including some scallions. So it went back into the oven for 5 minutes this time. Again, so the first time was for 20 minutes at 450 degrees Fahrenheit. We flipped it and went back into it for 5 minutes using the broil option, and then we flipped it again another 5 minutes. So it's just beautiful and perfect. I served it, as you can see here, with my party jollof rice and some coleslaw. All these recipes are coming up. Thank you so much for watching. Make it a great day and have fun, especially in that kitchen.